Alright. And we are here with our another episode with another guest. And today we are going to talk about how family and business, they go hand in hand. So today we have a daughter from a father-daughter duo who run a bakery, and she will be talking to us about the whole process of how it all started and the journey, and basically how did they reach this point where they decided to, you know, bond together as a team and just go ahead with this absolutely amazing venture. And so let's just, so her name is Khushbu, the daughter who will be joining us today, and she'll be taking the conversations ahead. So let's invite her and take this conversation ahead. Hello, Payal. All right, so we are just waiting for her to accept our invitation, and from there on, we'll take the conversation ahead.
Hello. Hi.
Okay, first of all, let's check all the audios and videos so you can see me, you can hear me all perfectly fine. Okay, there are some technical glitches as always, but it's quite alright. And we'll just wait for her connection to get a bit better so that we can take this conversation ahead. So by the way, today we have Khushbu with us from Mr. Mustaches. Is of a father and a daughter, and how they came about with this whole idea, and how did they, you know, basically started their journey. So that's what we'll be talking about, and obviously we'll be talking about their best selling cake and what would they recommend for everybody to basically definitely try it. So let's try and connect with her once again. Okay, till then, Payal, you and Nidhi can talk. How are you, Payal? I hope you have been doing well, and you're, you know, absolutely, I am pretty sure that you are doing really good. And let's try and invite Khushbu once again. All right, we are waiting. All right, that was a technical glitch for sure.
I told you this beforehand, this will happen.
Absolutely, but it's all right. You know, this has happened with me a lot of times in the episodes before this also. So we always find a way, so don't worry about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, it's possibly you'll live videos. Yeah.
Absolutely. So possibly you'll just keep coming and going. So that's quite all right, as long as, you know, the conversation keeps
not.
Going ahead. Yeah, keeping our fingers crossed.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So how are you, Khushbu? How are your days doing?
Well, I've just been working every single day. Like, you know, it kind of feels like a normal day. I don't feel stuff has been changed a lot as compared to the work area. Like, I have the same schedule. It's like we're online delivery service. So,
all right, yeah.
For us, it's been online since forever.
Oh,
how
wonderful.
How are things with you, though?
I would say pretty much the same as well, because the thing is that even the whole thing, my whole operation, you know, I have a home office, so it did not really change anything for me as such.
Right. No, or going out.
Yeah, so I did not really, you know, do that pretty much before this also, so it hasn't really impacted me in a bad way in that sense. But yes, there are a lot of people and, you know, a lot of stuff that is happening around the world, and just keeping our fingers crossed that everything gets better.
Right.
Soon, that's better. So, Khushbu, let's talk about your journey. Like, you know, so basically, I want to know your background, like, you know, your background and your father's background, and how did you guys basically reach this decision of starting something so wonderful. I want to know it all. Like, you know, just go on.
Okay, so I come from a fashion background. And I've been
All
wanting to
right.
start my business since the beginning, since like first year of my college. I have this aim that I will start a business, and I
All right.
actually started working on one of them. So
Okay.
during that time, for whatever anniversaries or birthdays, my dad had been cooking
Okay.
and baking. So initially, he had no plans of this, and he used to just bake out of passion, you know, sometimes on Sundays or on weekends. And he originally has a electronics store and mobiles and electronics. So he's completely
Okay.
into the technical side, and I'm into the fashion side. So
Right,
then
right, right.
I just told him, why don't you start this bakery, and it will be a good idea, because like these days everything is going to be online. So I also come from marketing background. I've worked at a lot of marketing offices. So
All right.
I was like, let me do the marketing sector and you do the product.
Okay.
So yeah, I pushed him a lot for this venture, and you know, one day he was like, fine, let's just go ahead. So one day, yeah, I was just sending a text to my friends that, you know, we have launched this bakery. If you want to place an order, you can go ahead. And suddenly,
Right.
my friend who's working with, who was working with Ramola Bachchan, so they were having their houseful exhibition in 2 days, and she was like, would you deliver 65 brownies tomorrow? And
Oh, wow.
I was like, big deal, like, I can't say no to that, but like,
Right.
I just sent out the message, how will that be possible?
Right,
But
right, right, right.
again, you can't say no to that opportunity. So I just went ahead with it, and we baked like day and night, and we tried to pack it, and like, yeah, we had the deadline of delivering it by 7:30, and we were there by 7:45-ish. And then, yeah, it was a done deal, and then since forever we've been going on like this.
Wow, I think that's absolutely a wonderful first break to sort of, you know,
Right.
just break into the business. Obviously, you could not know to something like that.
Yeah, we got a lot of appreciation and recognition at that time.
Wow, that's absolutely so. I'm sure that after that, it was just, you know, basically it helped you build blocks post that, because obviously people who were there, they got to know, okay, you know, this is so-and-so and this is from A-com. And yeah, it should have been a very, absolutely a great beginning. Absolutely.
So since then we've been doing a lot of exhibitions. Like we did one in December for Karen Anand, which happens basically in Pune, but like this time was the first time in Gurgaon. And we also did Horn OK and all the big exhibitions with the small ones. Like so, like kids love cakes, so all the Christmas carnivals and everything, that's where we were.
Wonderful, wonderful. So I really want to ask you one question here. That, you know, because you were trying to persuade your father to go ahead with it. So how much time did he actually take to finally say yes?
Oh my God, it was a lot of effort. Like right now also, I was literally pushing him to come in this video to just feature for once. He's like, no, I can't. You know how dads are. Like they're shy in front of cameras and they're like, come, you do this. It's your marketing area. And I'm like, fine, I'll just do it myself.
Right. Possibly, you know, maybe we'll do it some other time once again, and we will.
I hope so.
Yeah.
Once it becomes camera friendly. Yeah.
Yeah, but you know, you have done such an amazing thing. I have to give this to you, that basically pushing him to go ahead, because you know, from what you are telling me, this is his passion. Baking is his passion pretty much. So putting that into a business and you know, a profession and kind of everything in that direction, I think that's absolutely mind-blowing. So
yeah,
a very good job, Dankuji.
Yeah, it's basically role reverse. Like usually dads push their daughters
yeah.
forward and do this. Yeah, he's like, he never saw it as a business opportunity. He just felt like cooking for other people, and it made him happy.
Right.
Yeah,
right, absolutely. So I have to ask you one more question here, that you are coming from a fashion background. And now it's obviously, you know, something very different to what you have trained to basically do.
Yeah,
so how does that, you know, miss the fashion industry, or like how have you adjusted into this thing?
Oh, I do miss fashion industry a lot. Like it was completely different. Like then it was trends, forecasts, designs and everything. And right now it's just like baking sugar powder, baking powder, and I'm just like, oh my God,
all
I'm drowning in these ingredients. I don't know what this is. So I, like, it's a fun fact, I am not a fan of cooking and baking, so I don't enjoy doing that. So, all right. I'll just handle this sector, you handle that sector, and let's just keep it like separate. Let's just not mix them. Because, like, there was this one time when I entered the kitchen and my dad asked me to cut the chocolate for him, and I ended up breaking the plate. So, yeah, it's just no thing for me to do that.
All right, however, so you don't pretty much mix
yeah. Yeah, I do keep up with my apps, so I have some fashion apps downloaded and I do keep up with the trends and all, just for like my own sake.
Right.
Yeah.
But this is quite interesting, you know, coming from something absolutely different and basically what you have decided to do is you have decided to take your father's passion ahead, and that's, again, I have to say this, that's absolutely beautiful.
Thank you.
So possibly, maybe in the future, you might think of, you know, adding something onto your fashion venture, and maybe
that's
later on one
coming.
Yeah.
Right. That's my plan only. Like, once I'll stabilize this business, and as soon as this gets stabilized, I'll come up with another thing.
Right. And for how long you have been doing this?
Oh, this has just been like few months. 8 to 9 months.
That's amazing. That's absolutely amazing. And I was just, you know, going through your Instagram and I was reading some reviews, and you have some raving reviews. Like, people have been talking about your absolutely
Yeah, we just came on Zomato recently, like, I think 3 months back, and we're going to come on Swiggy also this month. So let's see, like, I hope we keep on growing.
Yeah, absolutely. My good wishes are absolutely there with you, and I'm pretty sure the kind of work that you are doing, I'm pretty sure there's a, you know, you will go a long way.
Thanks a ton. So I basically left my job to work on this. My dad is still, he's juggling between both his store and this. So he goes to work, like, this lockdown time, he goes to work for like few hours in the morning, and then he comes back and he starts baking. So recently COVID, we've been like, you know, revamping the menu. We've been trying on new dishes and what all can we add? How can we improvise?
Right, so that's what has been happening for past 40-45
years. Yeah, and also, you know, there were so many tasks that I was like lazy about, I'll do it later, this and that. Now that I can't step out, I don't have any excuse, so I'm just working on that.
Right, absolutely. Now there's, you know, I think a lot of people are doing that because now you have no reasons to delay a lot of things. Like, you are home. You have to do them. There is no way out. Like, even if you procrastinate for a while, then you have to tell yourself, you know what, there's no way out
it
now.
It has to be done. Yeah. Initially, I was just taking a break. I'm like, let me just like read for a while.
Yeah.
Catch up on my hobbies. But till when will you do that? You will have to work someday.
Exactly. Yeah, I absolutely understand that because, you know, even I did that for first few days. I was like, oh yeah, I'm free. But gradually, I was like, okay, let's get back to work.
Work keeps us sane. So, you know, during these times, like, this is the only thing that can keep you constantly like stable in life.
Absolutely. Because that's the only constant thing that you have right now. Everything else, those are the add-ons, more or less.
Right.
Absolutely. So on that note, let's take up our next question. So, you have already told us about, you know, the background and how it all started. So now I want to ask you that. So basically, again, the dynamics also, we have already discussed them, but still I would like to sort of, you know, like for you to tell a bit more about your roles and responsibilities and the relationship that you guys have and, you know, who is the one who actually ends up giving instructions, or are there, like, you know, particular scenarios where you are the one who's taking it ahead and sometimes your father sit ahead? So can you just let us know about that part?
Well, I'll let you answer this question for me. You can easily answer, like, who do you think would instruct one of us? What do you think?
I don't know. I think I have a feeling that you are taking the lead on everything. And your father is like, oh, you are saying it, I'll do it. Is that how it is?
Yeah,
pretty
that
much
happens, yeah.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, but like, you know, sometimes you have to, like, he's my father, I do have to listen to him. Yeah, so we have a role segregated. He does the baking, and he's always on YouTube trying to look for new dishes, trying to think, brainstorming. And I handle the marketing sector. I get more clients, I get more coverages, I get more promotions, business development. I look towards that side. And you know how like our parents and all, they're not very technology friendly. So, you know, I've been teaching him here and there, like, you know, how to use Instagram, how to go live, how to upload a story. So it's a mixture. Like, this is how I come in, and I am not very great at handling people sometimes. So that's what I miss out on. And then he's like, so sometimes I don't handle customer report very well. So that's why he handles that. And sometimes I take it on my heart. I'm like, okay. But like, he's like, no, like, that's not how you do it. Like, let me do it. And usually at the stall, I do represent the brand and all, because I have to do it. Like, that's my job, because he's put in like hours and hours of night into making the thing. So he relaxes at the stalls and I do the selling. And like, he knows the intricacies of all the cake and, you know, like things that he has added on in it. And he's more well spoken with other people, so that's where he comes into the picture.
Right. So basically, you guys keep switching roles at times. Like, sometimes he will step in and. So, do you also come up with possibly, you know, some new cakes or something new that you think that you guys should try? And has it ever happened that you came up with a solution? And he'll be like, no, we are not doing that. Has that ever happened?
I tell him, can we make this? And he's like, what do you think? Like, this comes out of nowhere. Have you read the ingredients? I'm like, no, like, I don't know how to make this. Can you, like, try it at least? Because then again, like, the age gap comes in. Like, our generation, we prefer, like, different kind of bakery stuff. And, like, they've been eating sweets and, like, rasmalai since forever. For them, it's a big thing. So they just kind of get used to the concept. Like, so this is our main motive as well. So a lot of people have been eating icing cakes and frosting cakes, and not many people like it. It's not healthy either. So
I'm one of those people.
Yeah, I just stopped ordering from outside. I can't eat it. And then tea cake you can have at any time. Like, you know, so if you have late night munchies or, you know, something for tea snacks, like, just eat a piece of cake. It'll fill your stomach and it'll be healthy for you. So I recently only I searched a lot of French dishes, you know, which we can try out, and then he's been working about that recently.
Wonderful I absolutely agree with you that, you know, like, the icing part of the cake, sometimes obviously some people don't really like. I know that feeling. It gets a little bit too heavy. So the concept of tea cakes, I think that's absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing. Yeah, and should be talked about. This should be, you know, this should be there completely.
And you know, like, by the, so it's supposedly someone's birthday, and by the end of it, I would see cake being thrown away, which would really be upsetting. So instead of just like throwing it away just because of the icing part, just eat the entire cake.
Right. Absolutely. So true. Absolutely. I agree with you on that. All right, on that note, let's take our next question. So what your days look like, you know, because you have been, like, you even during the lockdown, you guys are working every day. So how does it start? You know, start from the very morning hours, and how you sort of, you know, gradually sort of just end the day.
Right. I mean, it's COVID time going on. You don't know what's morning hour anymore. So I sleep very late and I wake up during the noon, so I start my day at that time. And it's the reverse for my dad. Like, he I told you, like, he goes to the store for like first few hours, so he'll be back by the noon time, and he'll start baking his dishes till like 5 p.m. and then he'll take a break. And work starts at 5 p.m. I sit down, I start with checking my mails, my notifications. So, like, I am aggressively focusing on social media for now. So, like, checking with the LinkedIn notifications, Instagram notifications, uploading the stories and posts. And then I would start, like, I start with making my to-do list. Like, that just makes things better. because like everything is just haywired. Like one person has to handle the entire thing. It gets crazy and out of hand. So I've made a lot of Excel sheets. Like I have a separate Excel sheet for database, for business development, for promotion. Like then I check all of them one by one, what has to be worked upon, what is lagging. And then, you know, here and there some fixtures, and then I start working normally, like, you know, connecting with people, getting work done.
Right.
So is there any point of time during the day that both of you sit together and discuss, okay, you know, this is, you know, so does that happen quite often, or does it happen on a daily basis, on a weekly basis? How does it happen?
Ideally, it should happen on a weekly basis, but it happens like if one of us is really furious at the work stage. So usually, you know, that's where the personal relationship comes in of father and daughter, because we both have our separate egos. How do we get it together? So that's what we're working upon right now. Usually, it happens, let's say, once and twice a week. And yeah, we have been working on this aspect, you know, to sit down and jot many points. But basically, the thing is, like, we can't really interfere in each other's sector. So usually, if we have to brainstorm, it's once in every 2 weeks. That much is enough.
Yeah, absolutely.
Otherwise, he's just baking on his own. I'm working on the marketing aspect. Like, he has completely different knowledge. So he won't be able to help me with the marketing concept. If I somehow do have doubts and all, then I go up to him. And he's just right here all the time. So, you know, also you don't have to sit with him to discuss stuff. You can just go up to him and talk to him.
Yeah, absolutely. Completely. Okay, so I wanted to ask you something here, and I've completely forgotten what that was. it was like right here. I spoke it. It's like, okay, out somewhere. I don't know. It's, that thought is, you know, out somewhere and just, yeah.
You can probably go through your sheet or like try to recall it.
No, I just, while talking, something you know, came up. Yeah. I'm completely missed on that, but that's quite all right. Possibly it will come back.
Yeah.
So till then we can go to next question. So what is your favorite part of the whole process? Like, you know, what is your absolutely like, you know, the thing that you completely wait up for and you're like, oh yes, you know, it's time for that. So what is that?
Definitely the exhibitions. Like that's when the time when people come up to your stall, they eat your stuff, they, if they like it, they appreciate it. And that's when you actually know where you're in the market, how well is your product doing, what is the response. And exhibitions are very lively anyway. So I'm an extrovert. I love talking to people, connecting with them at that time, talking to more vendors there, probably getting more leads. And, you know, my dad also, like, he gets more motivation to make more. And he's like, okay, my work actually getting appreciated here.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's our favorite time. You can also have fun at the exhibitions, like, you know, just like eat and try new dishes from other vendors and like while working at the same time.
Absolutely. So by the way, that question came back to my, like, I know what that was. So yeah, I wanted to ask you that when you guys are trying something new, so who is that one person who, you know, gives the final go for, okay, this is absolutely delicious and you don't need to do anything on that. So is it your father or is it you?
I think you know the answer.
Honestly, I really want you to, you know, just tell me on this one. Like, I am pretty confused on this part.
Okay, so he makes the final thing, but I do the testing and I tell whether it's passing or failing. But honestly, mostly it's been passing till now. So again, like the generation gap, like I told you. So our generation, we've been very, we have a lot of scope to eat and see what's out there, like according to our parents. Like they don't go out that much. They have maybe like YouTube or Google as the max exposure that they have right now. But for us, it's insane like how much exposure we have. So obviously I've tried out most of the dishes, so I know what's better, what's not. And honestly, till date, he's done a pretty good job. Like he hasn't, I don't think he's tried most of the dishes outside. And again, coming from a technology background and this, I don't think so. So according to YouTube and like, you know, he keeps following other bakers and their websites and Instagram. So now we have taught him how to use Instagram. So he's scrolling all day long for dishes. So according to that, he's done a great job, you know, trying to copy the exact thing and adding your own ingredient to make in Mr. Mustache's cakes.
Yeah, wow, that's absolutely, absolutely such a, you know, great thing that he is getting friendly with the technology and learning how to basically
get up. Yeah, so initially he was like, why should I do all of this? What will I gain out of it? I'm not even interested. And, you know, how will I learn? So now he can see the aspects of it.
Right, right, absolutely. So he's understanding that, you know, okay, doing this is actually adding on new flavors. Learning, more or less.
Yeah, it's a two-way learning.
Please go ahead,
It's a two-way learning. Like, he teaches me a lot of stuff, like, so he basically teaches me the emotional aspects of the business and I teach him the practical aspects of the business.
I think that's a perfect balance out there that, you know, both of you are maintaining actually. Because these are the two aspects that you have to.
Yeah,
because, you know, if both of you were on the same kind of plate, then it would have been a bit difficult.
Exactly, exactly. And personal relationships coming into business can make it stumble. So that's where we have to keep the balance.
Completely. So, okay, Khushbu, tell me something. What is your favorite thing that your father made? Like, which is your favorite cake?
Like, hands down. Yeah, like, that is also the chef's special. And it's like, whenever he makes it, it's just on point. Like, you can't say no to that cake ever.
Wow, I am actually, you know, honestly, I am now waiting to try all of your cakes and everything.
Yeah, very soon.
And okay, so, and what is your father's favorite, you would say, that something that he's like, okay, this is, you know, this is my thing, you know, something that he's absolutely
the same thing.
Oh, wow.
Because I think that's the best thing, like, you know, 100 on 100, like nothing less.
Wow, now I'm really, you know, curious on having that chocolate cake for sure.
The other day he tried making a mango cake and it had a little bit of icing on it. So that's where, you know, since I come from a fashion background, I have a little bit artistic hand. So that's where I tried the icing and it actually worked out. So I think that could be a next thing. Not like heavily focusing on icing, but just like one layer. Because like some people do prefer icing. So I just completely, not give up on that.
Yeah, like you have to, you know, find the balance somewhere that, okay, all right, you know, you guys absolutely. All right, so that's really good to know that, you know, you also basically keep trying your hand on the new dishes. Basically, if you're talking about the icing part.
I genuinely hope one day I am also in the kitchen helping him out and not breaking plates.
Yeah, so have you tried learning something from him, like on a very serious note, that okay, let's do it.
So one day I actually made a lot of chocolates with him. So there's this mold which gets a lot of tiny chocolates out of that. And I made that. That was fun and easy. So that's what I like doing.
Nice. So you have done, like, you know, some successful experiments.
And all that's why I added my own touch as well.
Oh, nice. So you definitely are sort of, you know, although you guys have your defined roles, but you keep crisscrossing, like, you know, you keep pulling him to this side a little and he keeps sort of, you know, all right, just lean in a little and learn this part also.
Exactly that, yeah.
All right, so that's quite, I think that's quite great actually. All right, so let's take up our next question. All right, so we have talked about your favorite part and what is your least favorite, like, you know, the thing that you just have to do and you're like, oh god, why do I have to do this, but you know you have to do it.
It's the one making calls. So you know how we are all texting generation now and we hate talking on calls, but again, we know how important calls are. So as soon as I know I have to call a certain amount of people, I procrastinate for hours and then I end up doing it and I'm like, okay, it's done.
Yeah, all right. So that's like you're like, okay, let's keep pushing it aside till till the time you can.
I talk to you happily on text, but calling is just like, I would.
Yeah, you know, absolutely. From the tech generation, obviously, this. Like on a very serious note, that okay, let's
yeah,
do it.
Yeah. So one day I actually made a lot of chocolates with him. So there's this mold which gets a lot of tiny chocolates out of that, and I made that. That was fun and easy. So that's what I like doing.
Nice. So you have done, like, you know, some successful experiments.
Yeah. And all that's right. Why I added my own touch as well.
Oh, nice. So you definitely are sort of, you know, although you guys have your defined roles, but you keep crisscrossing, like, you know, you keep pulling him to this side a little and he keeps sort of, you know, all right, just lean in and learn this part also.
Exactly that, yeah.
All right, so I think that's quite great, actually. All right, so let's take up our next question. All right, so we have talked about your favorite part, and what is your least favorite, like, you know, the thing that you just have to do and you're like, oh god, why do I have to do this, but you know you have to do it.
It's about making calls. So you know how we are all texting generation now, and we hate talking on calls, but again, right, we know how important calls are. So as soon as I know I have to call a certain amount of people, I procrastinate for hours and then I end up doing it and I'm like, okay, it's done.
Yeah, all right. So that's like something you're like, okay, let's keep
pushing
it aside until
yeah.
the time
I
you can.
I talk to you happily on text, but calling is just like I would.
Yeah, you know, absolutely. From the text generation, obviously, this
certain amount of people, I procrastinate for
so. Our next question for you is that, all right, so what is, you have talked about so many things already, but I am going to put you in a little spot right here, and I'm going to ask you that, what is that one thing that people absolutely cannot miss, and they should, if they are ordering, what is that one thing that they can just, you know, close their eyes and be like, okay, let's just go ahead with this, and it would be absolutely mind-blowing.
I think it can be chocolate dipped marshmallows. Because a lot of people are still getting used to the concept of marshmallows, and if you give them with chocolate dip in it, they absolutely love it. And they're like, oh, what is this thing? I haven't tried in ages, and they suddenly eat it and they love it.
Uh-huh. All right. So I hope, you know, everybody keeps a note of that, and yeah, they have to remember it. All right. So Kuzu, I am, so, you know, we have talked about this, that the whole episode is divided into two sessions. So this session is all about, you know, the video on Instagram and interacting with the audience and everything. And I am absolutely waiting for our next session, which would be the audio call. I know you hate calls, but, you know, let's just get on a call and we'll talk about, you know, so many cakes and so much about your journey and how a lot of, basically we'll be talking about the things in depth, and that episode will be put up on the podcast on YouTube and everywhere. So before ending this video session with you, there is one last thing that I want you to tell the audience, that is, you know, how to order your product, and after that, post that, we are going to do a quick rapid fire session, and I'll be just throwing random stuff at you and you have to answer them. Before that, tell people how to order from you guys and how to connect with you.
All right.
Or basically, if there are bookshops that should be, you know, they should know about something that you are possibly planning to come up with, and how to possibly be in your mailing list or anything. So please just go ahead and shoot.
Yeah. Okay. So, if staying in Gurgaon, so you can order from Zomato, and currently delivering as well. So we're keeping all the hygienic conditions in mind and precautionary measures. are staying in Delhi, then it's right now, but you can still order website. It's MrMustachesCakes.com. And we will be on Instagram. If you're following us on Instagram, I can upload the links if you guys want. And it's basically Mr. Mustache Cakes only.
Right. And are there any workshops that possibly you guys are planning about and, you know, people should know about so that they know that immediately they can get on the mailing list and go ahead with that? I think Khushbu, there is some delay or technical glitch and there is some misconnection. So let me do one thing. Let me just add you once again.
Right. So on our website only, we have the workshop category available and also subscribe to the website. Uh-huh. So we can have your email ID and contact.
Yeah, I think there is some technical glitch. Let me just, you know, add you once again.
Okay, all right.
All right. I think we are having an amazing conversation here and I think it's going really well. And I absolutely love the idea of, you know, a family working together. It's like a family business where the father bakes everything and the daughter takes care of all the marketing. So I think it's a beautiful dynamic that these two have been working on. And I am honestly waiting to try their cakes and everything. And I think it would be really good. And we are just waiting for Khushbu to get back online and she can tell us how to order the cake and how to get in touch with them and if there are any workshops that these guys might be coming up with and how to get in their mailing list and all of those information once Khushbu is back with us. And we are just waiting for her to accept the invitation once again so that we can take this conversation ahead. And till that time, guys, all right. Just a second. We'll do it once again. All right. Welcome back.
Yeah. Is this better now?
Yeah, definitely. Because I think there was some major lag because, you know, I could see you speaking, but I couldn't hear a thing. So let's get back.
Okay.
That how can people order, how can people get in touch with you, and how can they get in the mailing list if there are any upcoming workshops that people should know about. So please, I'm really sorry you have to do it.
So
this again.
We're on Zomato for now. So people who are staying in Gurgaon, they can order from Zomato. And on our website, every detail like how to order the delivering in Delhi. But like we're just waiting for the circumstances to get a little cool down and then we'll properly deliver in Delhi. But till then, we are taking online workshops, which is one-on-one. So we're not holding a group workshop. It's like each person has different capacity to learn. So not process of learning. We're taking one-on-one workshop. We also have a degree on our website where you can just subscribe and fill your email address. And we will contact you directly.
That's quite wonderful. You know, these one-on-one sessions, I think they sound really great actually for people who actually want to learn.
Yeah.
I think this is what is needed.
Right.
So I think that's a great initiative that you guys are going ahead with. So Khushbu, let's end this session with a rapid fire round. I hope you are absolutely ready for your, you know, moment of
this. Yeah.
Yeah. Just basically, I say something and you just say whatever comes to your head, like the first thing.
Sure.
Yeah?
Let's do it.
All right. Yeah. So your first prompt is superpower.
Superman.
All right. That's a good one, actually. You know, you are not really limiting things and you're like, okay, if it's the superpower, then I just want all the superpowers that Superman has got. Like, you know, make it simple.
Yeah.
All right. So your next prompt is, okay, the song that comes to your head immediately. Just maybe, you know, just close your eyes and think of a song and it will just come to you. Something that you were listening to during the day.
Feverish, bothered, bewildered. I do listen to a lot of songs. So I'm a music lover. So like throughout the day, I'm listening to different playlists and different music.
All right. So can you just suggest me some
but
artists?
Like, the song that comes right now to my head is Feverish, Bothered, by Bewildered.
All right. So actually, you know, I really...
So I love all the old classics, what people have been...
Wow. So can you just maybe just, you know, give me some names of...
Go ahead.
Some suggestions, maybe. That, you know, something that the way we talked about your cakes, maybe some songs or some artists that you think that I should definitely give a shot.
I mean, the favorite ones of people all listen to. I mean, we should all
I love them. All right, so let's go to your next prompt. Okay, I think I've again lost your voice or something. Yeah, I'll add you once again. All right, we have been having a lot of technical glitches on this episode, I believe. And hello everyone who is sticking by and being a part of this absolutely amazing episode about cake and baking and a father-daughter duo. So it has been an amazing conversation so far, and Khushbu is back and we are going to ask her the next prompt immediately without any further delays. All right, Khushbu, what was the last movie that you saw?
Right.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I saw Call Me By Your Name last night. It's about me.
It's about, I'm sorry.
Hello?
Yes, hi, can you hear me, Khushbu? Hello.
I think this... Is it better now?
I think so, I think it's better. Alright, so what is the last movie that you saw? Let's give it a shot once again.
Yeah, I can hear you. One second. Can you hear?
Yes. Can you hear me?
Okay. Yeah, so I saw By Your Name last night.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I can.
All right, perfect. So, all right, your next prompt is that, okay, so, you know, I think everybody associates people with colors. So what would you say, what color are you and what color do you think your father is?
Oh, I think I would be pink and he would be... What reason I'm saying that but, just came to my mind.
Well, you know, that's the whole idea. That's the whole what this activity is about. You know, whatever comes to your head, you just say it. So I'm so happy that you just, you know, said the color that immediately came to you.
Right.
All right. So we are going for our last prompt for the evening and it's Mr. Mustache. Nice. All right. So I think, Khushbu, this was an absolutely amazing session and I loved talking with you. And I'm really looking forward to our audio conversation because I think, you know, this can go into much more depth and I would love to learn more about your relationship with your father and more about your business and more about your journey. So thank you once again for agreeing to be a part of this and thank you. Okay, I think Khushi here wants us to repeat something. couldn't hear the last answer. So can you just maybe repeat the last answer?
It's been a pleasure on my end as well.
All right, thank you so much, and let's connect on.
Probably wouldn't want. Oh, Mr. Mustache answer was that.
Yeah. All right, Khushbu, once again, thank you for agreeing to be a part of this. Let's connect very soon for our podcast.
So when I think of Mr. Mustache, my dad comes to my mind.
I think that's the whole, you know, that's the whole idea about, basically, I really wanted to know, you know, with this prompt, what, where would it take you? And I think you have given the perfect answer. All right.
Thank you. So thank you so much for having me.
Thank you. And let's connect very soon for our audio call. Okay. Bye-bye. All right, guys, I think this was an absolutely wonderful session with Khushbu. It was, you know, I think even you guys got to know a lot more about the brand, and even I got to know a lot more about the brand, and I am really looking forward to this conversation and for more conversation with Khushbu. And guys, thank you for sticking by. Thank you for being a part of Shruti Out Loud. We will keep bringing more and more interesting and inspirational guests for you guys. And if you have any suggestions, if you want anyone to sort of, you know, be a part of this, then just send me a DM and just, you know, connect me with that person, and I'll be very, I gladly bring them on board for this conversation. So have a great night. I hope you guys are having a great week, and I will see you on Friday with our another guest. So thank you.